Hi friends, welcome to Math A to Z. In this class, we give an important theorem, statement with proof, about countable set or enumerable set. Okay, what is the important theorem? The important theorem is the union of a finite set and an enumerable set is enumerable. Okay, this is the statement of the theorem. Union of a finite set and an enumerable set is also enumerable. Okay, this is the theorem or this is the question. Now we give the proof of this theorem. What is the proof? We first let enumerable set as S and finite set as P. Okay, S be the enumerable set. Since S is enumerable, so there exists a bijective mapping from N to S. Right? This is the definition of enumerable set. And we know that the element of S can be written as A1, A2, to An, this type. Okay? So we get the enumerable set as this. And since T is a finite set, let the number of element of T is M. So the set T can be written as T, this is equal to B1, B2, to Bm. Okay? Now here two cases may arise. One case is two set S and T such that S, this is S and this is T in Venn diagram. So S intersection T, this is equal to phi. And another case is S, this is S and this is T. So S intersection T not equal to phi. Two cases may arise. We first discuss the first case. If S intersection T, this is equal to phi. If S intersection T, this is equal to phi, then we define a mapping from natural number to S union T. From the set of natural number to the set S union T. As f of I, this is equal to bi for I equal to 1, 2, to m. We take the first m element by the first m natural number 1 through m. Okay, that is f of 1 equal to b1, f of 2 equal to b2, and so on. F of m, this is equal to bm. Now, after m natural number, we get m plus 1. And we take the mapping as f of m plus I, this is equal to ai. This ai from the infinite set S. Okay, so f of m plus 1, this is equal to a1. F of m plus 2, this is equal to a2, and so on. And clearly, this mapping from n to S union T, this is a bijective mapping. Okay, so we say that S union T is an enumerable set. This is the first case. Now, if S intersection T, this is not equal to phi, and this is the intersection portion, then we define another set S1, this is equal to S minus T, and this is S1. Okay, clearly this S1 and this T, if we take union, then we also get S union T. But here S1 and T, these are the disjoint set. Okay, so in this case, if S intersection T, this is equal to phi, let S1 this is s minus t, we say here, and s1 union t, this is equal to s union t, also s1 intersection t, this is equal to phi. So we use here the case 1, and by using case 1 we say that s1 union t is a numerical. Why? Because s1 is an infinite subset of innumerable set, and we already proved in the previous class the infinite subset of an innumerable set is innumerable. Okay, so s1 is innumerable, and t, this is given here, this is finite. So this s1 union t is union of a finite set and a innumerable set. Okay, and also s1 union t, this is equal to s union t here. So this must be innumerable, that is s union t is also innumerable. Hence in both cases, if this is equal to phi and if this is not equal to phi, in both cases s union t is innumerable set. Okay, this complete the proof of this theorem. And if we want to see previous theorem and definition of countable set, we get the link in the description box. Please follow Math A to Z. Thank you for watching.